Hey guys and gals, I'm here with a video. Today might be a fun one, might not be. Depends on what you're into. This was going to be initially be a Patreon / YouTube membership exclusive video, but I have not been posting a lot of content lately, so I thought, hey, let's put this out there for everyone to possibly hate. But the older I get, the more I'm getting into toy lines from my childhood, whether it's things that I had a great number of figures from, or some that I had one thing from, but I really, really liked it. This is one of those toy lines, and that is Titan A.E., a movie that didn't perform very well. I have fond memories of it. I still enjoy it today. To this day, I think it still looks very great. The only toy that I had from when I was little was the Valkyrie ship with Kale. The only way to get Kale in his just casual attire. And I loved it. And I don't know what it was, but for some reason, I kind of just had this inkling to look up the Titan A.E. toy line. Couldn't tell you why. Woke up at 5 a.m. and I was like, hey, let's see how much these are going for. Well, I don't know how regarded the movie is in this day and age. I have no idea whether it's as loved by others as it is by me. But the toy line is for the most part pretty cheap. So I wound up buying 8 figures from it. This isn't all of them. It wound up being like $6 to $7 per figure. And as you can see, they are all still sealed. Well, one thing that I personally enjoy doing when I start getting into a toy line, if it is sealed, I like testing out all of their electronics, all of their gimmicks. Do the features still work? How corroded are the batteries? These are things. This is a toy line from, I think, 2000 itself. 2000 Hasbro. So before we get started, I got to get a few things out. Obviously, we got to open the toys. Then we got to take apart the things that have electronics. And then we got to test the batteries. So I got all my little things out. I don't know what kind of screwdriver I'll need. I don't have really a certain plan how to tackle this. We're just going to go through them one by one and try them out. So I figure let's start off. We got the Inferno Battle Dredge with pulsating battle lights. I do like how the figures show how their features work. So that's nice and handy. And I got to say, I don't like the feeling of the dredge. I don't know if the plastic is degrading. It has a very, I don't know if you can see it in the light. It's got a very oily residue. I'm going to have to wash these guys because this does not feel good to handle. I do not like that. But the dredge had a really interesting design in the movie, being just beings of pure energy. They captured that look pretty well. I don't know if you can see how just greasy my fingers are getting. I think the plastic is degrading. So that's great. Let's put you right there for now. Did not plan that to go as badly as it did, because ew. So here's its little attack sled that it comes with. It does have a missile launcher. That is really just push it out. So let's try the lights, which I don't even know where the lights are supposed to be coming from. Safe to assume this one's dead. So let's crack open my screwdrivers. I think it's a safe, but I'm not even going to really have to test the batteries on these. My big concern is just how much corrosion I'm potentially facing. So let's just, oh! Are the batteries not included?
A few moments later.
Requires 2 AAA batteries. Not included. Requires 2 AAA batteries. Not included. Not included. Well, oh god, I'm so stupid.
12 seconds later.
On the plus side, it means that there will be no corrosion inside the toys. On the other hand, this was a totally wasted video because I don't have to check anything. So I'm gonna keep going because, hey, you know what? We've already started this. We've already started on this journey together. I'm gonna go grab some AAA batteries and a wet cloth to hopefully clean up some of these figures.
1 minute, 37 seconds later.
Gotta say, I didn't really see this coming, but you know what? Fine. You know, I'm not gonna complain too terribly. We're just gonna go through, clean these guys up, try to remove some of that oily residue, and, you know, this could be a good thing. It means that there's no risk of corrosion. This guy feels so disgusting. I kind of want to just submerge it in hot water and just see what happens because ew. Give this guy a nice little dry off. see if this helps at all. I'm really hoping that the other figures don't have the same kind of problem. All right, so I don't know what this thing is supposed to. I'm guessing it just has a little blinky light. So let's just see. Oh, it's with pulsating battle light. That's a pulsating battle light. So let me get this guy out of here. Hope you guys are ready. This is what we're in for. For seven more figures. Some of them do have sounds at least. But, ooh, that's not what I expected at all. So we're just going to leave that. I didn't grab a bunch of batteries. I'm not going to leave everything batteried up. But just, I don't need my battery tester anymore. I'm still throwing off. All right, let's move on to the X200 hover vehicle with Corso. And, like, if there was any hint about who the bad guy of the movie is, just look at that face. Ooh, here's his little hover sled, which I think looks pretty cool. I haven't seen Titan AE in a few years. I don't know how much these weapons and vehicles actually popped up in the movie itself. He does come with a little gun, which I think is pretty neat. We got to love his little missile launcher. That is just, again, a little ball joint that fits right into there. Like, that's not a bad vehicle. Now, can you actually sit in this? Oh, I think it's just a matter of, here, let's just get his hands. Let's just tuck his little feetums in there. Let's give him a gun. And there we go. Modern road rage at work. So let's pop in some batteries. So what features did this one say? This one has battle action sounds. I'm pretty excited. Here's the button, and we get... Oh, no.
A little longer than a few minutes later.
All right, so I had a little progress, and if I can't get going again, I'm going to play the audio that I had off camera. But I just sat here kind of spinning the batteries and trying the button over and over again. I got some sound out of it, so the wiring does work. Oh, hang on. All right, so it wasn't doing this earlier. I'm actually getting different sounds, and it might be when you push it different times, you get different sounds. Before, it was just looping one sound. Maybe, like, the button got stuck. So let's try this again. So that might be how it's supposed to sound. I don't know. If anybody has this, let me know. But, that's way better than it sounded when I first turned it on. It was just a horrible grinding sound. So we're going to put Corso back in there. I'm going to take these batteries out. So, that one works as far as I know. I guess let's just keep on going. Up next, we have the Dredge Blast and Stiff with battle actions. I gotta say, when it comes to vehicles, I like this one quite a bit. Assuming it's meant to be a vehicle, maybe it's meant to be just like a battle platform. The missile replicates the other side there. That doesn't come out. I think it looks pretty cool. This was Janine Garofalo's character, if I remember right. Decent little sculpt. Stands okay. I mean, you can get the legs a little more hunched over. But, so let's get you opened up. And see if we have the same problem as Corso. Let's see. If you can hear it a little any better. A little quiet, but the sounds are distinct. It works. I'm not going to complain. I feel a lot better. I really don't have to take apart all these figures and try to fix them. I'm not Toy Polloy. So, not a bad design overall. A little weird. It's just a little weird. Oh, you know what? I need to take the batteries to this one so I can keep using them. I don't have enough triple A's for all these guys, so we gotta kind of be a little stingy. So up next we have one of the many Kale figures. It's one of those toy lines where it's like the Shadow. The main hero gets like four different figures, and we don't even have the full cast. Like, there's no figure for Goon. I think it was John Leguizamo's character. I feel like there's someone else who's missing, but like, we got all these Kales and just no Goon ever. This is the Space Walker suit and Kale with pulsating battle light, which we know how the pulsating light looked on that one. So far, this is definitely the heftiest of the toys. This Kale, like, I don't... Oh, he's sticky, too. Ooh, not all over, but his translucent bits. Like, you know what? If that's... Let me see if you can see that in the light. Is that a glob? Oh, it's actual sculpting. Okay. Yeah, his feet and arms are just goopy feeling. And it's not pleasant to touch. So, like, it makes you wonder, like, if you bought these opens, are they going to feel worse? Are they going to feel better? I can't help but think that, like, all this goopiness is going to attract dust and carpet fibers and all kinds of things. Like, it's gross as is, but I can't imagine how much better it would be if it was actually goopy and covered in stuff like hair. So he feels a little bit better now. Obviously, Kale didn't dress like this in the movie at all. He does have a little gun that I don't think you can store on this anywhere. That's such a weird design. Like, I like it, but strange. So let's open up you. All right, so for the full effect, I guess you'd pop out the missile before you can even load Kale in. This is so weird. This is weird. There's no pegs for his feet, so you gotta just kind of put him in and just grip the joysticks and just pray. Oh, his feet are not even on there. All right, I got him on there. His feet are actually on the little pads now. I don't know where he can... I mean, he could hold his gun, obviously, but we're not gonna do that now. So let's pop in the missile. And... That's not bad. It's, you know, it's not exactly great. It's way better than whatever that little light was. So does it turn off when you push the button again? Nope, it stays in until it just cuts off on its own. So there's Kale and his his power walker. Oh, okay. Let me go ahead and pull these back out. I do like the little detail on like his windshield showing like a radar and kind of stuff. So that's something. But yeah, another Dredge. This time it's the Dredge Attack Drone. I especially love how this one is just laying down on its little thing. That's how it fights. And of course, being that it's translucent, it's gonna be nice and goopy. This is a little weird for their ship. That's how it's supposed to be. There's the missile, there's the button. I really do like that the two Dredge you get. And there's a third one that comes with their ship. Are different molds, at least like the arms are. The legs might be the same, the torso and heads might be the same. But the arms are at least different. So like you can kind of army build these guys, but like his buddy, he's a goopy mess, and I don't want to touch it. So that feels a little bit better, a little less gross. Just put you there. Let's put in some batteries for this weird little thing. I have the lowest of expectations for this, given how the other Dredge fighter worked out. All right, I had to put the battery cover back on for this one, because it's got a little peg that fits my little buddy, and he really just fits on, just like that. Oh, it's not even gonna fit on the peg? Ah, I had to kind of tilt his torso up, so it's not totally laying down. And here we go. What's it gonna be? Oh, it's, yeah. So, I mean, it's better than that, but I mean, you could say it's like a laser firing, okay. Most exciting, I'll be the first to admit, but it's something. We'll just pop you right back on there. So yeah, so far, aside from Corso's, I'm not sure if his sounds the way it's supposed to. I've never looked up videos on this toy line, so I don't know what he's supposed to sound like. Again, if someone has these guys, let me know what your Corso sounds like. I would be interested in taking it apart and maybe replace the speaker if I need to, but so far not bad. That was your gun. You might think that I'd be done, but if you were paying attention, I said I bought 8 figures. So now we have the Ark Runner in Kale, which actually did appear in the movie. It was in the first scene, the first scene with adult Kale, with pulsating battle light. This is getting redundant. I gotta say, I like this one way more than the Walker. This actually did appear in the movie, so that's in itself a nice thing. I don't know if there's a way to store his actual gun. I don't remember what it did in the movie on his vehicle. It's got a little peg where he can hold it, so I'm sure there's any kind of holes where you can plug it in. I feel like there should be a way to store this on here. There's a little peg in the back that if this had a hole in, you could just pop it around there, and I'm not opposed to doing that, just drilling a hole and storing it there. I like that Kale's helmet can come off, even though that's an additional accessory that you could wind up losing. One thing I didn't notice is that he's got translucent feet and hands, much like his other vehicle version, so I haven't even cleaned the goop off those yet. So, for his pulsating lights, we got... Which isn't, you know... It's not horrible. It doesn't do a whole lot, but... Oh, alright. Sure. I'll just bathe him later. Little gun. And so that's what I have in terms of the basic figures. The pulsating light is definitely not that exciting. The sounds aren't bad, just... I'm not sure if my Corsos is dying. So interestingly, they made deluxe figures, and... As far as I can tell, it's just the exact same kind of thing, just... Oh, God! Terrified me. With battle action sounds. The vehicle is a bit bigger. I'm noticing how translucent Kale is. I'm not looking forward to that. Let's go ahead and put this guy up here. Keep him kind of wedged where he's standing upright. So apparently, one of the prerequisites to being a deluxe figure is that you need to take AA batteries. I did not know that.
Flashback.
Double A's.
No. Dang it.
End of flashback.
This is one of the weirder vehicles. I don't know if I like it or not. I find it weird that Kale holds on to the windshield. And I can't tell if it's... You know what? I was going to say, I can't tell if it's a magnet or just some kind of force that kind of holds him and locks him in place. It might just be his legs being sticky. Because he holds on pretty well. Like, if you put him there, you can see, and then you just... So, I don't know if there's something that actually locks him in place or if it's just his legs being sticky. I have not cleaned him yet. And it could be possible that this, and maybe this, appeared in the montage scene when they were building the Phoenix. I don't know. I know there's a montage. As far as I know, this did not appear in the movie. And it's interesting, to say the least. It does have a very, very long missile that I really want to trim up. But this one supposedly has battle sounds. So let's see what it sounds like. I don't even know where the speaker is. Oh, there's the speaker. So we get... Which I can only assume might be laser shots. It sounds like the speaker is a lot higher quality than the other ones, at least. So that's something. But we'll put you there. And, you know, one thing I'm kind of thinking about, these are 2000s Hasbro products. I'm wondering if there might be a risk of gold plastic syndrome for these kinds of pieces. I don't think so. I mean, I don't want to really risk it. They feel like there is some flex to them, but that's one thing I got to take into consideration when I mess with this. That as well, it has that same kind of gold look that the Shadow Toys have and Beast Wars. So I don't know if 2000, if they still have that problem. So the last figure I have to show you guys and to try out is the other deluxe figure. The one that really matters, this is the Dredge Queen, or the Rapid Attack with Battle Action Sounds. She doesn't look that translucent.
She might not be sticky.
Well, I'm just confused overall because Dredge Queen takes AAAs. So apparently I lied about deluxe figures taking AA batteries. That's kind of what I assumed. Check the packaging for your toys before you start putting batteries in them, kids. That's all that I can really say. Where did I put my screwdriver? Found them. We're good. She's not too sticky. There's like the slightest bit, but... She doesn't have translucent bits like the others, and Can her legs even move? I don't think her legs can move. So she is literally just park it. I don't think her legs can move. I don't want to risk breaking them. Maybe they can. She starts to lean forward. We're just gonna put them back where they were before. Her whole rapid attack thing is you push on the back of her head, she goes, "Oh, it's an actual missile!" I hadn't tried it beforehand. I thought it was one of those things where it's like it would shoot out that far and then you lock it back in place. I didn't know you actually launch her face as a missile. So that's something. Just gonna put that right back in there. All right, so, ooh, her head can actually turn. All right, so battle sounds. I don't know what to expect, so here we go. That's the same sound. I don't know what I really would ex what I expected from the Dredge Queen, but not that. This is probably the worst figure of all of them. Oh my goodness. All right, so that is it for this video, guys and gals. This was quite an adventure. I don't know when I'll be covering this toy line in the future. I would like to say it's going to be soon, but I still need to buy all the ships. And the Valkyrie goes for like over $100, and I'm not willing to spend that much for it. So at some point we'll get to it. I still need to get the two other figures. I think it's EVA Titan Suit Kale and some kind of battle attack pod tripod thing that comes with Preed. So once I get those, I would love to cover this toy line in full. For those of you who are looking forward to such a thing, you got kind of a quasi review here. But wow, this video really had some ups and downs, didn't it? Anyway, guys and gals, I thank you for watching if you've made it this far. If you enjoyed this and you want to see more, I got stuff at the top to subscribe, watch previous videos down below. I got a Patreon and a YouTube membership where I sometimes post things like this. Again, if that's your sort of thing. But I hope you all have a great day and I will see you around. Take care.